गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल माई, यू आर ऑल डूइंग वेल, यू आर फाइन एंड यू आर सेफ एट योर होम्स एंड यू आर ऑल्सो स्टडिंग एवरी डे. चिल्ड्रन, वी हैव बीन डूइंग एडजेक्टिव्स. आई डिस्कस विद यू द काइंड्स ऑफ एडजेक्टिव्स. We did a few exercises also. Then we did the degrees of comparison. And I also told you the difference between older and elder, okay, yesterday. Now I gave you a homework also where you had to find out the 3 degrees of comparison of the few given words, okay? So let's see that homework. Yes, here. So the question was, give the comparative and superlative degrees of these adjectives. Okay, so these are 28 in number, and I hope you have done your homework, but let's discuss it so that it clarifies if you have any doubts. Now, first one is sad. So sad is sadder and saddest. D doubles, so it becomes S-A-D-D-E-R, sadder, and S-A-D-D-E-S-T, saddest. Okay. Then we have hot again, H-O-T-T-E-R, hotter, and H-O-T-T-E-S-T, hottest. Okay. Then cold, cold is, you add E-R and E-S-T, so that becomes cold, colder, coldest. Then you have little. Now, I told you yesterday about little. What does it become in the other degrees? Little, less, least. Okay? Little, less, least. Then you have late. So, late is later and latest. Later and latest. Then you have fit. So, fit again, T becomes double, so it would be fitter, F-I-T-T-E-R, fitter, and F-I-T-T-E-S-T, fittest. Okay, then lucky, lucky, luckier, luckiest, L-U-C-K-I-E-R, luckier, and L-U-C-K-I-E-S-T is luckiest. Okay, then you have long, so long, longer, longest. Then many, many, more, most. Many, more, most. 10th one is much. So for much also, it becomes much, more, most. What's the difference? I told you, many is for countable nouns and much is for uncountable nouns. So many is adjective of number and much is adjective of quantity. Okay. But the degrees of comparison are same. Many, more, most and much, more, most. Then 11th one is bold. So it is bold, bolder, boldest. Okay. High, high, higher, highest. Then if you want to know the spelling, bold, B-O-L-D-E-R, bolder, and B-O-L-D-E-S-T, boldest. Then H-I-G-H-E-R, higher, and H-I-G-H-E-S-T, highest. Then fine. So fine is finer and finest. F-I-N-E-R, finer, and F-I-N-E-S-T, finest. Then broad, broad, broader, broadest. B-R-O-A-D-E-R, broader, and B-R-O-A-D-E-S-T is broadest. Then you have gray, G-R-E-Y, gray. So G-R-E-Y-E-R, grayer, and G-R-E-Y-E-S-T is grayest. Then you have active. So active is more active and most active. Then old is older and oldest. Clean, clean is cleaner and cleanest. Holy is holier, H-O-L-I-E-R, holier, and H-O-L-I-E-S-T, holiest. Then charming, more charming and most charming. Okay, cheerful, again, more cheerful and most cheerful. Then costly, costliest, costlier and costliest. C-O-S-T-L-I-E-R, costlier. C-O-S-T-L-I-E-S-T, costliest. Then expensive, expensive, more expensive, most expensive. Okay. Strange, strange, stranger, strangest. S-T-R-A-N-G-E-R and S-T-R-A-N-G-E-S-T. Okay. Then famous, more famous, most famous. Then you have hardworking. Hardworking will be more hardworking and most hardworking. Far. Now far, I explain you the concept. Far can be far, farther, F-A-R-T-H-E-R and F-A-R-T-H-E-S-T, farthest. And it can be far, further, F-U-R-T-H-E-R, further and F-U-R-T-H-E-S-T, furthest. So what's the difference? Far, farther, farthest. Farther and farther stands for distance. Okay. That means I have to go farther than this. Fine. And further stands for position. Like I tell you, we'll study further about it in the next class. Okay. So that is F-U-R-T-H-E-R, further, and F-U-R-T-H-E-S-T, furthest. Okay. Then you have good. So good is better and best. Good, better, best. Okay. So that was all about your homework which I gave you. And I hope you have understood how to write these comparative and superlative degrees of all these adjectives. Now, we have another exercise. Yes. Now, read the two sentences given here carefully. Anita is taller than her sister and Anita is the taller of the two sisters. Now, what is the difference? Actually, the difference is in the way of writing the sentence. Otherwise, the meaning is the same. When we are saying Anita is taller than her sister, we are comparing Anita's height with her sister's. Okay. So, we are saying that Anita is taller. Then when we are saying Anita is the taller of the two sisters, that means Anita has another sister. And we are comparing the height of the two sisters. And Anita is the taller one. Okay. So actually, it's one and the same thing, but the way of saying it, the way of putting it up is different. Sohan is more active. See this B sentence. Sohan is more active than his brother. Sohan and his brother are being compared according to their being active. Now, Sohan is more active of the two brothers. That means out of the two brothers, Sohan is more active. So, it's one and the same thing. Now they're saying, now frame meaningful sentences using the words given below. The first one has been done for you. So Keshav, intelligent, and his brother. So Keshav is more intelligent of the two brothers. Okay. Keshav is more intelligent of the two brothers. And if we want to put it in another way, we'll say Keshav is more intelligent than his brother. Okay. Keshav is more intelligent than his brother. Then second one, is Athira lazy, her sister? Athira is lazier. Athira, what would be the comparative degree of lazy? Lazier. L-A-Z-I-E-R, lazier. Okay. So Athira is lazier than her sister. This is one way of putting it up. Athira is lazier than her sister. Or we can also say that Athira is lazier of the two sisters. Athira is lazier of the two sisters. Okay. Then third one, Mr. Saxena, generous, his neighbor. So Mr. Saxena is more generous than his neighbor. Okay. This is first way. Mr. Saxena is more generous than his neighbor. And the second way would be Mr. Saxena is more generous of the two neighbors. Mr. Saxena is more generous of the two neighbors. Okay. Now, Sharat kind his cousin. So, Sharat is kinder than his cousin. Sharat is kinder than his cousin. And Sharat is kind of the no, wait a minute. We'll not say here of the two because it is cousin only. So we'll say Sharad is kinder than his cousin. And in the third sentence also, we'll say Mr. Saxena is more generous than his neighbor. That would be better because neighbors can be many. Okay. So Mr. Saxena is more generous than his neighbor. Otherwise, if you also say that Mr. Saxena is more generous of the two neighbors, then also it's correct because we know that we are talking about only two people, Mr. Saxena and his next door neighbor. Okay. Then Sharad is kinder than his cousin. Okay. Or otherwise, you can also say Sharad is kinder of the two cousins. So Sharad is kinder of the two cousins. That's also fine. And Sharad is kind, kinder than his cousin is also correct. Now let's see another exercise. Yes. Read the sentences given here as an example and frame similar sentences with the given words. The first one has been done for you. Brahmaputra long and Kosi. Brahmaputra and Kosi, both are the name of the rivers. So the Brahmaputra is longer than the Kosi. Okay. Now gold, costly silver. So gold is costlier than silver. Next, we have cashew nuts, costly peanuts, of course. So what would be right? Cashew nuts are costlier than peanuts. Cashew nuts are costlier than peanuts. Then Rashi, pretty Ragini. So Rashi is prettier, P-R-E-T-T-I-E-R, prettier than Ragini. Rashi is prettier than Ragini, okay? Then Raghav, talented Harsh. So Raghav is more talented than Harsh. Raghav is more talented than Harsh. Okay. Now, one more exercise of this sort. Yes. Read the sentences given here as an example and frame similar sentences with words given below. The first one has been done for you. Shashank, tall class. Shashank is the tallest boy in the class. Mukesh Ambani, rich man in India. Mukesh Ambani is the richest man in India. Okay, so we are using your superlative degree. Okay, so Mount Everest, high peak in the world. So Mount Everest is the highest peak in the world. Mount Everest is the highest peak in the world. Now, Raman, thin boy in the class. Raman is the thinnest boy in the class. Children, just remember, before superlative degrees, we write the. Okay? So, Raman is the thinnest boy in the class. Abida, talented girl in the senior school. So, Abida is the most talented girl in the senior school. Abida is the most talented girl in the senior school. Okay? Now, just see here, children, what's written over here? Each one of us possess different qualities. Yes, they all have different qualities. Is it right to compare one with the other? Why or why not? So we are actually learning how to compare two or more than two people. But then they are asking you, that is that correct? See, when we are compared with our friends or our brothers and sisters, we do not like that. We do not like being compared to others because we know that we have our own quality. Okay, similarly with everyone. We do not like to be compared with everyone. Okay, so yes, comparison in one way may not be good, but if somebody, just think that if somebody else tells you that that person is better than you, then we don't like it. Okay, definitely we don't like it. But if we sometimes sit and ourselves think and compare our some quality with somebody else, okay, and then we don't feel bad, because then we think that okay, if that person is good, is better than me in some way, then I'm going to prove everybody wrong and I'm going to do better. Okay, so comparison, when done in a positive way, gives you motivation and inspires you. Okay, and otherwise, like Mount Everest is the highest peak in the world. Okay, so such kind of things, such kind of comparisons are needed for the facts and figures, for the statistics, for the facts and figures, for the general knowledge of the world. Okay, so such comparisons are fine. And if we compare ourselves, we should not compare anyone with anyone else. But if we are compared, then we should take it positively and we should try to do our best. Okay, but we should remember, we should believe in ourselves. Okay, we should always believe in ourselves that we are, yes, we are best in at least something. So, and we can always do better. Okay, at any stage of life, at any at anything, we can do better. Okay, always. So take the comparisons in the positive way, and we ourselves should not compare the two people. Okay, any two people, that's bad. If we are doing it for some statistics, if we are doing it for some facts and figures, then it's fine. Okay, now let's do another exercise. Read the following sentences and tick the correct one. The first one has been done for you. Burj Khalifa is the most tallest building in the world. Now, there is a cross in front of it. That means it is not correct. Now, why is it not correct? Let's see the sentence. Burj Khalifa is the most tallest building in the world. Children, tallest, what is it? T-A-L-L-E-S-T. Tallest is superlative degree. Okay. And what is this most? Most is much more most. Many more most. Most is again superlative degree. Do we need two superlative degrees together? Do we need two superlative degrees? No. Actually, if we remove this most from here, then tallest itself is working well out here. So we do not need this most. We do not need this double superlative. So what would be the sentence if we correct it? Burj Khalifa is the tallest building in the world. So this is wrong. Because of the use of most here, we should remove most from here. Okay. Then so you now Shalini is more kinder than Sana. Shalini is more kinder than Sana. Again. Now, is it correct or is it not? See, let's see. What is kinder? Kinder, kind, kinder, kindest. So kinder is comparative degree. And what is this more? Much more, most. Okay. So what is this? This is again comparative degree. So do we need two comparative degrees together? Do we need double comparatives together? No. When we write Shalini is kinder than Sana, then the sentence is perfect. But if we write more kinder, then it is double comparative and this makes the sentence incorrect. So we will remove more from here. And but if we are putting more, then this is wrong. Okay, this is a wrong sentence. We should remove more from here. Now, Suresh is the most efficient person in the organization. Is this correct or not? Yes, this is correct. Most efficient. Efficient is the positive degree. When we are comparing, we have to put it in the comparative degree. So what would be the comparative degree of efficient? Efficient, more efficient, and the most efficient. So we are putting it in the superlative degree. We are comparing Suresh with all the other people in the organization. Okay, so superlative degree, most efficient, perfectly correct. So Suresh is the most efficient person in the organization. This is a correct sentence. Now, Rita is more shorter than Rashmi. So Rita is more shorter. Again, now see, shorter, short, shorter, shortest. Shorter is comparative degree. What is more? More is again comparative degree. Now, two comparative degrees put together. So this is wrong. Now you know. So more should be removed, and otherwise this is a wrong sentence. If we remove more from here, this becomes correct. Okay, let's see here. He is more braver than his brother. Now more braver, braver is comparative degree, brave, braver, bravest, and more braver is double comparative. So we do not need double comparative degrees. So this sentence is again incorrect. And what do we have to do to make it correct? We have to remove more from here. Okay, so he is braver than his brother. Okay, now let's do one more exercise. Okay, read the following passage and underline the adjectives. Okay, who's this? This is Mother Teresa. You can all see. So this paragraph is about Mother Teresa. And now we have to underline all the adjectives which we can find. Okay. Now, Mother Teresa was a kind lady who served the sick and poor people. Okay. Now, Mother Teresa was a kind lady. What kind of lady was she? Lady is a noun, children. And what kind of a lady was she? Kind lady. So what is this kind? This is adjective. And what kind of adjective it is? It is adjective of quality. What kind of lady? Adjective of quality. Okay. You remember, for adjective of quality, we get the answer to the question, what kind of? Okay. Then Mother Teresa was a kind lady who served the sick and poor people. What kind of people? People is noun. Okay. So what kind of people? Sick, poor. So sick, poor, both these words, they are adjectives. Now, what kind of adjectives they are? So what kind of people? Sick and poor. So this is again, these are adjectives of quality. Okay. So kind, sick, poor, all these are adjectives of quality. Okay. Now, next line. All the generous and humble people who wanted to help contributed willingly. All the generous and humble people, again, children, what kind of people? Generous, humble. So generous, humble, these are the qualities. Okay, somebody's qualities. What kind of people? Generous, humble. So these are adjectives of quality. Okay. She could not bear to see a hungry child or an ailing person and was keen to serve them. She could not bear to see a hungry child. Okay. Now, what kind of child? Hungry. Okay. So this is again adjective of quality. What kind of child? Hungry. Adjective of quality. Then, ailing person. What kind of person? Ailing person. Okay. Now, ailing, this, I told you, this is participle adjective. The words with ing, these are participle adjectives. So, ailing person. So, ailing person, ailing is participle adjective. Okay. Now, there is a big home called the Missionaries of Charity in Kolkata. So there is a big home. What kind of home? Big home. Again, adjective of quality. Big home. Where many people are taken care of. So how many people? Many people. Okay. So many is, you can count people. Okay. So many is adjective of number. Okay. Adjective of number. Many is adjective of number. Okay. Okay. Then the underprivileged and the needy are looked after well. The underprivileged and the needy are looked after well. So what are the adjectives? the adjectives are underprivileged and needy. Okay, so underprivileged and needy, what kind of adjectives are they? These adjective of quality. Okay, yes, what kind of people? So underprivileged people and needy people. Okay, now wait a minute, the underprivileged and the needy. Okay, the people who work there get great satisfaction by doing so. The people who work there get great satisfaction. What kind of, how much satisfaction? How much satisfaction? Great. Can satisfaction be counted? Satisfaction cannot be counted. So satisfaction is uncountable noun. And what kind of, how much satisfaction? Great. So great is adjective of quantity. Okay. Okay. So children, hear this sentence, the underprivileged and the needy. Underprivileged and needy are nouns. They are not adjectives. Okay. What kind of, underprivileged people and needy. So these are actually, when we say underprivileged, we are speaking about all the people who are underprivileged. When we are talking of needy, we are speaking of the whole class of needy people. Okay. So now we have done this adjective. Okay, let me share the PDF once again with you. Yes, look here. The underprivileged and the needy. Underprivileged and needy is adjective only. Needy means needy kind, needy people. And underprivileged means underprivileged people. So this is adjective only, okay? So underprivileged and needy, these are adjectives only. And these are adjectives of quality. Okay. Okay. So now we have done the adjectives. We have done the adjectives. And we have done all kinds of adjectives. We have done the 3 degrees of comparison also. Okay. And we learned what mistakes should be avoided while using the degrees of comparison. Okay. Now, children, in tomorrow's class, I'm going to give you a practice of adjectives. So I'm going to give you exercises. We are going to do some exercises so that the concept of adjective becomes very clear to you. Okay. So that's all for today, children. I hope you have understood well. Now, just keep safe, take care of yourselves and everyone around, study and enjoy yourselves also. So till we meet next time, just keep safe.